collapse, repressing true expression, cementing this repression, promoting mass deception so that no one can be healed. I don't respect your system, I won't protect your system. When you talk, I don't listen, only have my father's will be done. And just get out, oh just get out of all this bondage, just get out. Just follow the majority, afraid to face reality. The system is a joke, or you'd be smart to save your soul. Oh, and escape this mind control. You spend your life in sacrifice to a system for the dead. Oh, are you sure where's the passion in this living? Are you sure it's God you're serving? Obligated to a system, getting less than you're deserving. Who made up these rules, I say, animal conditioning, or just to keep us as a slave, or just get out of this social purgatory, just get out. All these traditions are a lie, just get out. Superstition killing freedom, knowing my condition is the reason I must die.
This song though, people, this song though, god damn it, I love it. That's why I, you know, played so much of it. But yeah, thank you for that song, Lauren Hill. I fucking love you and your songs. Okay, peace to the gods and goddesses on earth. I'm grateful for all the blessings that this universe and this earth keeps on giving us. And I'm very grateful for all the souls that are here on earth right now to elevate, to upgrade this reality. Because that's what we fucking need to do right now. We need to step into our godhood, our god self, and make this reality more to our liking. So what I wanted to talk about today is the something along those lines of what this song is talking about. So as you probably know, the Aquarian age is upon us, and that means that we all need to think outside the box. We all need to come up with new things, new ideas, new ways of doing things, of living, of thinking, of feeling. Everything should be a new thought pattern and a new way of living, a new system, a new kind of people. We need to elevate this goddamn shit. I'm tired of this goddamn world we're living in. I'm tired of this 3D dimensional fucking shit. I'm fucking tired of it. And we can't stay here. We can't stay here. It's time to move the goddamn on. Okay? So, we all need to step into our God self and focus on you and yours. So, we got 4 years before Pluto goes out of Capricorn and into Aquarius. This is when we want to be in our own space already. When I say being in your own space, I mean do your own thing, not depending on anyone else. So build your business now and work hard, because 4 years from now, you'll be very thankful that you did. And the system is only getting more unpredictable. And this is the time for change, so be and create the change you want to see in the world, period. There's nothing else to it. I don't want to sugarcoat anything or make it more complicated than it is. It's very simple. And I can't say it enough times. Step into your God self. What I mean by this is figure out what you want during this lifetime. Excuse me. Find your higher self. Find your higher self, aka your best self, aka your God self. And the questions you want to ask yourself is, what do you want to create? What do you want to do? What do you desire to do? What do you desire to create? You see, everything apart from you are a distraction to you and your dreams and your mission. Because we all have a mission here, individual to ourselves. I will go into further detail to your mission and how to decipher your mission in another video. But, as I said, everything apart from you are a distraction to you and your mission. When or if you meet a person or see an opportunity that might benefit to you or your dreams, make it a part of you. Make it a part of your mission. Make it a part of your reality. Don't let that go by. Because, you know, it's only, you only have so many chances of making that your reality, or else it will, you know, drive by you. And we really need to look at our lives and remove what is not healthy for our mission. And this goes into so many levels. So you need to take it step by step and remove one thing at a time. Take it step by step, not everything at one time. That will be too much. So take one thing and remove it, then another thing and remove it, and replace it with a good thing. Something that will improve your life, something that will motivate you, inspire you, something that will bring you closer to your God self, your higher self, your dream, your mission. So, remember you, remember who you are, remember your mission, remember why you came here. And remember that you are the only person that matters most to you. And the same goes for your dreams and desires. Nobody cares as much as you do about your dreams and desires. That's why you gotta be the one to work hardest on your dreams and desires. Because everyone else don't give a fuck. Might sound a bit harsh, but when you have manifested and you have completed your goals, or you have come far in your journey, far in your mission, then people will recognize you for what you have done and who you are, who you have become. So fuck everybody else. Let them come to you when you are, you know, when you have done what you want to do and you're on your path to improving yourself. Let them come to you then. Don't go look for anybody else. So, I say, fuck everybody else, focus on you, focus on you, okay? Step into your God self, I can't say this enough times, and make these dreams a reality. That's the most important thing you're doing here. And as I said, I will go into further detail on how to figure out your mission for this lifetime. I will say it very simply now, just study your North Node. Your North Node is your mission here in this lifetime, and your South Node is what you did in your previous life. So study your North Node, and study the house of your North Node as well. It's very important. And to understand or to figure out the house your North Node is in, you need to have your time of birth into your astrology chart, okay? I will make a video about this on how you do it specifically, so it will be a bit easier for people. Yeah, So that will be coming up very soon. And the last thing I want to say is we all should be moving towards a sustainable lifestyle, a sustainable future for ourselves. So think sustainable. Think sustainable and how to sustain yourself and not depend on anyone else in this system or anyone else for that matter in our world, because it's not wise. It's not if you do that, you're gonna set yourself up for things like you're gonna set yourself up for unnecessary circumstances in your life. So we need to be on top of our lives and, you know, focus on what matters the most to us. And what matters the most to us down here? Our dreams and desires, of course, but also, you know, having the security or having the security of a place or a safe place to be, with the food we need to sustain ourselves, with the sunlight we need to sustain ourselves, with nature, with what you need to sustain yourself and be happy in the circumstances that you want to live. You know? So you will see me in the tropics in a few. I don't want to say years. Let's say a few years, just to be sure. I'm not entirely sure since this fucking coronavirus is all happening, and I don't know when I get to leave this country. So, thank you. Thank you to everybody. I'm deeply, deeply grateful for all of you. Until next time, be God.